employed. I recently became a Muslim a couple months ago, and I took my Shahada here in Tokyo at the local mosque, Tokyo Kami. And I had a question about the Shahada. There's two parts. And I understand the first part, and I understand why that's essential to become a Muslim. But the second part, I'm unsure of why that is essential statement of faith to become a Muslim. And I also had a question about Charles Darwin. Is it true, or what does Islam say? Some people think that he was tutored by Lucifer himself.
He was tutored.
Tutored by Lucifer himself to induce spiritual blindness among humanity to delude people away from the kingdom of God. And I just wanted to know what was the Islamic point of view about that.
Brother, there's two questions. MashaAllah, he accepted Islam a few months back in Tokyo, and he asked two questions. The second question he asked was regarding Charles Darwin. Was he tutored by Lucifer? Was he tutored by the Satan or the devil so that he misguides a human being from the straight path? And his first question was, he understands the first part of the Shahada about La ilaha illallah, there's no God but Allah. But why the second part, that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger? I'll answer the second question first and then the first question. As far as Charles Darwin being tutored or being told by Lucifer or by the devil to misguide the human being, Allahu Alam, I don't know. But I know for sure that today, science doesn't agree it's a fact. There was a time, maybe several years back, maybe a few decades earlier, even when I was in school, though it was a theory of evolution, it was taught as though it was a fact. But today there are many scientists who disagree with it. That's the reason I said that today scientists are not eliminating God, they're eliminating models of God. So this is a test. Almighty God says, He tests different people in different ways. So what I believe, that it is testing the human beings. That do you believe in the Creator, or do you believe in things which are the natural selection? It's a test. So anyone who has reason and logic and knows science, as Francis Bacon said, little knowledge of science will make you an atheist, in-depth knowledge of science will make you believe in God. So whether he was tempted by Satan or not, but we know today that it is not true. Coming to your first part of the question, that you do know and you agree regarding the first part, that there is no God but Allah, and the speech dealt on that. And I believe that that may have convinced you more regarding the first part. Mm-hmm. What is the requirement of the second part? The first part says that there is no God but Allah, there is none worthy of worship except Almighty God Allah, and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Why is the requirement of the second part? The requirement is there because Almighty God says in the Quran, says in Surah Fatir, chapter 35, verse 24, وَإِمْ مِنْ أُمَّةٍ إِلَّا خَلَافَ النَّذِيرِ. There is not a nation or a tribe to whom we have sent a warner or a guide. That means Almighty God has sent a prophet in every nation, every age. Allah says in Surah Ra'd, chapter 30, verse 7, Allah says, وَقُلْ لِكُمْ مِنْ حَادٍ. And to every nation have we sent a guide. By name, 25 are mentioned in the Quran. Adam, Noah, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, Muhammad, peace be upon them all. Now, Almighty God, this religion is the same religion which was taught from day one. Adam, peace be upon him, was also taught Islam. Islam means, comes from the Arabic word salam, which means peace. It's also derived from the Arabic word silm, which means peace acquired by submitting our will to God. So Islam means peace acquired by submitting our will to God. Many people have a misconception that Islam is a new religion which came into existence 400 years back. And Prophet Muhammad is the founder of this religion. It's a misconception. Islam is there since time immemorial, since man set foot on this earth. And Prophet Muhammad is not the founder, but is the last and final messenger. Now Almighty God sent messages to the human beings, but by the passage of time, the message got distorted. Then Almighty God sent another messenger, another message. So Quran says in Surah Al-Hajj chapter 13 verse 38, that likulli qaumin hal. That it says that every age have we sent a revelation. That in every age have we sent a kitab. Now, previously by name four are mentioned in the Quran. Torah, Zabur, Injil and the Quran. But there were many revelations. So now as God sent the revelation, sent the book, sent the messenger, people distorted, he sent a new message. The new message. Finally, 1400 years ago, he sent the last book, the Quran, and the last message, Quran, and the last messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. You may ask me, why did not God send the Quran in day one only? Correct? You can ask me. Reason is Almighty God wanted the human being to be able to grasp the message. The basic message of Islam and all the scriptures same. God is one, he has got no images, but the finer points, how to pray, not to alcohol, all these came later on. So Almighty God, for example, my son wants to become a medical doctor. Suppose, he doesn't want to become, just the hypothetical statement. And he says that, so I tell him, okay, go to nursery, go standard one. He said, no, I want to go to medical college directly. I said, first go to nursery, then first standard, second pre-primary, secondary, plus college, then medical college. Stages. So Almighty God created the human beings. He knew when was the right time to reveal the right message. So he knew that 1400 years back, at this time, the human beings have developed that they can grasp the message. Then he sent the last messenger. That's the reason all the previous messengers and the previous messages, they were meant only for their people and for that time. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, all with the Quran. In Surah Imran chapter 3 verse 49 and Surah Saf chapter 61 verse 9. He was sent only for the Jews. The Bible says in Gospel of Matthew chapter number 10 verse number 5 and 6. It says that, go ye not into the way of the Gentiles. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says the apostles. Go ye not in the way of the Gentiles, but rather go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says in the Gospel of Matthew chapter number 15 verse 24, that I have not been sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. So all the messengers that came before were sent only for their people. And the message they brought was only meant for a time people, for a particular time period. Therefore, Almighty God did not think it fit to preserve it. Now when Almighty God sent the last message, the Quran, and the final messenger, the last message, the Quran, is not sent only for the Muslims or the Arabs, sent for the whole of humanity. Mentioned in the Quran in Surah Ibrahim chapter 14 verse number 1, Surah Ibrahim chapter 14 verse 52, Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse 185, and Surah Zumar chapter 13 verse 41. Similarly, the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not meant only for the Muslims or the Arabs, he was sent for the whole of humanity in Surah Anbiya chapter 21 verse 107. Now, because in the last message Almighty God says in Surah Hijr chapter 15 verse 9, I have revealed the Quran and I have guard from corruption. Now, why it is important that the name of Prophet Muhammad should be mentioned? To say that all the previous messengers that came, their message, the basic message is valid today about one God. But the other things are not valid today. All the messages that came before, they have not been preserved in the same form. Quran is the last and final message which Almighty God will preserve it. That's the reason, besides saying that there is no God but Allah, we have to say Prophet Muhammad is a messenger. There are two reasons. One reason, to know that we have to follow even the teachings of Prophet Muhammad. Because the Quran says, Atullah, Atul Rasul, obey Allah and obey the messenger. So besides the Quran, the teachings of Islam is according to the Quran and the teachings of Prophet Muhammad and the Sahih Hadith. So the two reasons why his name has to be taken. Number one, follow Allah's word, that is the Quran, and follow the guidance of the messenger, the teacher, our teacher, Prophet Muhammad. And the second reason is mentioned because the complete Shahada says, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. That, or Ishashadu La ilaha illallah, Wa Ishashadu Anna Muhammad Abdul Rasul. That say there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and Prophet Muhammad is the servant and messenger of Allah. So when we say he's a servant and messenger, we are being reminded he's not God. Because most of the other religions, they have made the messenger into God, like Christianity. Most of the Christians believe Jesus Christ is God, peace be upon him. He is not. So the two reasons his name is taken, number one, to follow his advice that is mentioned in the Sahih Hadith. Secondly, to remind us that he is a messenger and he is a servant of God and he is not God. Therefore, it is compulsory. Hope that answers the question better.
Thank you very much.
So hope now your iman has strengthened better. Now I believe that your iman has strengthened more.
Yeah, I think so too.
Strengthened more about the first part and the second part.
Yeah. Okay,
thanks a lot.
Definitely. Thank you.
You're welcome. So anyone who believes in logic and anyone who believes in science has to believe that there is God. So today's talk of mine was in proving the existence of God. So whatever you guess of my lecture, half or 75%, whatever it is, I am asking you, are you convinced about the existence of God or not? Who could have mentioned about that equipment which no one in the world has seen?
Yeah.
Who is the first person? My question was in the lecture. Who is the first person who will tell you about the mechanism of that equipment which no one in the world has seen?
So honestly, I was astonished about the story you told us about the scientific findings and the Quran that was mentioned in, well, about